wrong gates. Who you know gon' face? I see them keep trying, professional imitators. Rep, where's the flag? Now you're making me mad. With 47, get that. You better get back. Like, did you forget we know you're not with any inch of the real. So stop it. I ain't knocking your little hustle, but watch it. I would hate to hear that loud. Ooh, jitty, jitty, bang, jitty, jitty, bang. Oh, them cannons ring, yes, them cannons ring. Make sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same. Sure you fold already when you see the game. I thought I told you lames, we are not the same.
On EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida, with the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone. The Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Baltimore Ravens. Justin Tucker ready to go here. This is going to be a ton of fun. Ravens and Bucs, here we go from Tampa. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. First carry for Leonard Fournette. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. He picks up three on that carry.
Run got three. Now here's second and seven. Brady gonna throw. He'll swing this out to Fournette. So the completion good for just three. And just like that, it's third down.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense, because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. Now a first carry for Giovanni Bernard. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Fakes the give to Fournette. Now Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Throwing now is Brady. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 35. And the Ravens are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. After the interception, here's Jackson. That ball caught. It's Mark Andrews, the tight end. Pass the 20.
Pass him in this.
Pass him in this. Way in for a Ravens touchdown. Mark Andrews, 59 yards. And the Ravens are on the board first here on the road in Tampa. Tucker with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And he'll wind up getting a couple extra yards here for his trouble and bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Run got a couple here, second and 8. From the gun, it's Brady. And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes. Like a freight train off the edge, Calais Campbell with a sack.
He seemed to have a reasonable amount of time in the pocket, but he couldn't get rid of the football, and the end result, Charles, him on the ground.
Yeah, he's got to keep an internal clock to go along with his offensive line. When you're talking about 3, 4, 5 seconds, that's a reasonable amount of time to expect to deliver the ball downfield. So great to try and complete a pass, but it's equally important to know when to throw the football away, too.
The sack backs him up, third and long. Tough challenge for Brady in the box. On the draw, here's Bernard. And down he'll go at the 25. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a fourth down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And where will this be spotted? The side judge says it went out just across midfield. Run.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. They'll run with Dobbins, and he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Jackson gonna run. Option play, and they'll hand to Dobbins. And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. J.K. Dobbins. A 5-yard touchdown run. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 14-0. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be out of bounds here just past the 20-yard line. Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
The punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn into first downs and hopefully points.
Second and 8. Shotgun now for Brady. And this throw incomplete. The defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
They'll wind up losing 3 here on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
To me, this is a case of if you're not getting the ball, you've got to do your job and block for the guy who is, because there really wasn't much there. And boy, the defense took advantage with that loss.
And the defense, they were just locked in there on third. They had more guys than they could block. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A surprising move to go for it, predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Jackson on first down. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
Three.
Throwing is Jackson. Over the middle here to Brown.
Yeah,
and in for the Ravens touchdown. Hollywood, Marquise Brown. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Ravens are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Tucker with the extra point, and that makes the score 21 to zip. Boy, I guess they're going to keep trying to put the pedal to the metal here. They're going to try an onside kick. And the Buccaneers able to recover. Their hands team does its job. Second quarter onside kick there that failed. Is that something that maybe they had dialed up before this game started?
It feels like it, doesn't it? That they thought they had the right situation, you know, and the right approach in going after it. Also may signal that they feel like they have the superior team, that they can try these sorts of things and it won't come back and hurt them later.
Fournette, a first down carry. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Now it's Brady. That's complete to Tyler Johnson.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Brady. Hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after three plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on fourth down. They'll go for it. It's Brady. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. They can't get the stop here. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. The Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And that'll be incomplete.
You definitely would have liked to have hit on that one because now you've got a third and long showing up, and you just know defense is going to be getting after it. They are pinning their ears back, and they are coming.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Brady. On the screen, Bernard. And he'll get it down here to the 43. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Brady not coming to the sideline. They're going to go for it here on fourth. Here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucs may have moved.
about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
Hey, check back, check back, back six, back six. 50.
On play action, it's Brady. They'll roll him out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And the Ravens force the turnover.
It was for show, just so you know.
We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Don't want your bro. It was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. 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 Lit, lit, lit. Any, many, money, mo. All this money, I need mo. Give him a show, killing you nose and taking your bro.
And spinning his bands, oh yeah, did it again, oh yeah, out with his friend, oh yeah, Chanel is the lens,
okay.
With his friend finna get lit, I'm everything on they wish list, which bag should I get, which color should I pick, any, mini, money, mo, all his money, I need mo, you big bro, gotta go, big bird, giving crow,
a group of baddies coming foe,
give me money, kiss my toes, don't with your bro, it was for show, just so you know,
we just wanna get lit, we just wanna get lit.
For show, just so you know,
okay.
We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit.
Lit.
We just wanna get lit.
Lit.
We just wanna get lit.
Stop
lit, lit, lit. Any, many, miny, mo. All this money, I need
okay.
Mo. Give him a show, killing you nose and taking your bro.
We just wanna get lit.
Stop lit.
I shall come forth as pure gold. Have you been tried in the fire? Have you been tried in the fire? Well, tell me, did you come through as pure gold?
You kick it like the benefactor's benefactor. Well, truthfully, we know you never been a factor. Well, honestly, the truth is that you've been an actor. And now your actions got them boys about to mass up. Lectures from the devil got you piping hot. This up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do
what's up, Frank?
Rap a lot.
What's up,
I went and got my
not much, man. How you been?
Your favorite, bruh. You don't want no trouble, cuz. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's where rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip up in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, no, be not.
Not really, man. Just chilling, working.
The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me.
How about you?
Me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend on me.
Yeah.
Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's. If
weather's starting to get nice.
They took a but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up.
Hey, you
I could re-up with.
Had
to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart, he found forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got home, I paid him back and told him it was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times.
Be
asking for permission in a bank of line. Cause of who I been, check out how I tend to mind. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt an injured mind. He have your woman.
Okay, I know.
I keep my eyes on glory, oh, tell the devil.
Why you know how that lady came here?
Mind, the devil made me offers I decline. We're not aligned, not combined. I am not confined to any wicked system that these demons have designed. They frame a
mind. It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Bill Stadium in upstate New York. A few moments ago, to the delight of this Buffalo crowd, it was the Bills racing out of the tunnel as they get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And we are underway in Buffalo. From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The 35. With these run pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now Allen. Works right side into the hands of the tight end, Knox. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
On second down, here's Allen. He'll get this out wide to Singletary.
I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. A big pickup there on the scramble.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, you're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
After at least.